render passes can be super complicated when you're just starting out as a 3D artist. Of course, you can just blindly add them together by watching tutorials on YouTube, but once you fully understand what each pass does, you'll realize its potential and that'll only end up in you being creative. So that's what this video is about. I'm going to demystify Blender Cycle's render passes. But what are render passes and what do they do? Why do we even need them? Well, render passes basically contain certain data from our scene, which we can then use to manipulate things in compositing. For example, light passes contain data about the materials, textures, and lighting in our scene. We can use that to change the lighting in post or even change the textures. Pretty cool, huh? So over here in the scene layer properties tab, we have a bunch of passes and Blender has divided them into three sections: data, light, and cryptomats. And today's video will focus only on the light passes because they are the most important ones in my opinion. There are a total of 4 light passes, which are diffuse, glossy, transmission, and volume. And these are further subdivided into direct, indirect, and color, except for volume, which doesn't have a color pass. So before we move on to understand what diffuse, glossy, transmission, and volume does, first let us understand what direct, indirect, and color means, because they seem to be a part of every pass. So here we have a room, a camera, an object, and a light source. The reason we see a lighted scene with all the colors and materials and everything when we hit the render button is the same as how we see everything around us in real life. The light source emits rays, which then hits the object, and then the rays are bounced back to the camera, or in real world, our eyes. Now, the light source just doesn't emit a single ray. It emits a shitload of rays that bounce around the room like crazy. This is because Blender Cycles uses ray tracing. Higher the sample, accurate the rays will be. Now, the light rays that emit from the light source and hits the object directly and then is bounced back directly to the camera, just like this one, is called direct lightning. And indirect lightning is the opposite. It's the light rays that emit from the light source and then it directly or indirectly hits the object, then bounces around the room before finally bouncing back to our camera. There you go, that was easy. You can of course watch this part again if you do end up getting confused. Now, color pass just contains the color information. Really, you'll see what I mean in a sec. So in this example, this is the diffuse direct pass, this is diffuse indirect pass, and this is diffuse color pass. And when you combine this, we get our final rendered image. Voila. Okay, so now we know what direct, indirect, and color means in the render passes context. So what about diffuse, glossy, transmission, and volume? Well, this is all related to the materials that we have in our scene. Really, I'm not kidding. Back here in the shader editor, this is the shader that I have on my object, and as you can see, it's not that complicated. I just have turned down the roughness, which would make the object a bit glossy. And by glossy, I mean shiny and reflective. Now, every diffuse thing about this object will be stored in the diffuse pass, and every glossy part of this object will be stored in the glossy pass. You'll notice that the transmission and volume pass for this render is blank or empty. That's because our object has no volumetric or transmissive property. If I add another object and then max its transmission, then if we hit render again, you'll see that now we have something in this, in the transmission pass. I am not rapping here, just saying. So to summarize, all the lights in our scene emit rays, which then hit the object. It directly bounces back to the camera, and some of the rays bounce around the room and then make their way back to the camera. Now, the info collected by the rays are divided into 4 types, which are diffuse, glossy, transmission, and volume. Then these are further subdivided into direct, meaning the light rays that directly enter the camera after hitting the object, and indirect, meaning the light rays that bounce around the room and then enters the camera, and color, which just contains the color information. So there you go. Now you know what these passes mean. Now, let's see how to assemble them in Blender's compositor. Blender has its own formula, which is you add the direct and indirect, and then you multiply the color with it. Here's an example. Let's add in a mix node, then connect the diffuse direct and diffuse indirect to the top and bottom socket respectively. Then change the blend mode of the mix node to add. Then add another mix node, take the output from the previous mix node and plug it to the top socket of the new mix node, and then take the diffuse color pass and connect that to the bottom socket and use multiply as your blending mode. Do the same for the glossy passes and the transmission and volume if you have any. Then combine all of these using again the mix nodes and use add as your blending mode. The result, of course, will be the final or combined image. So then, why did we do this? Well, to have more control over things. For example, I can increase or decrease the glossiness of the scene or an object in the scene. So, in a later video, I'll show you guys how to creatively use these passes. So, don't worry and let this all sink in. Until then, be infinite.